What if I told you there's a way to save hours of work in Excel without buying any fancy add-ons or using third-party tools? Sometimes getting data into Excel feels like an uphill battle. Files don't match up, formats get messy, and you're stuck spending way more time than you need to. What if there was a built-in feature in Excel, one that you might not even know exists, that could turn hours of manual work into just a few clicks? And even if your current Excel workflow is not giving you any problems, keep watching because you might discover a smarter way to work that will save you time down the line. Now, to follow along on your own computer, you can get the Excel file and sample data in the video description. Let's begin. Here's the situation. I'm a data analyst for a kitchenware retail chain. I've received a PDF with all the sales transactions from the start of January to the middle of June. Here's the PDF. I want to get all the data from here into Excel so I can analyze it. And there's 20 pages of it. So naturally what I'm going to do is what everyone else tries, which is use Control A to select all, Control C to copy, then head back into Excel and press Control V to paste. But wait, it does not look good. The data has been put into a single column and there's no way I can analyze anything like this. Let's try using text to columns to clean it up. Click on the data tab and then go to text to columns. Now I want delimited, click on next, and I'll choose space, get rid of tab, and click on finish. Oh dear, that didn't work. In fact, it's a mess. You see this transaction ID column, the header for that should just be transaction ID, but text to columns has split transaction and ID into two separate columns. Then we have a store like New York and a store like Los Angeles split across two columns. Then look over here, the price, quantity, and revenue, all the numbers are a big mess. Nope, this is no good at all. I'm gonna have to find another way to do this. In level one, let's explore what Excel has to offer for working with data. Previously, we used the text to columns feature on the right here. Let's have a look to the left. There's this section called Get and Transform Data, and there's a dropdown next to Get Data. Let me click on that. Ooh, and it's showing us from file. Oh wait, there's also this from PDF. This looks promising. Let me click on this. Here's the file we want, so I'm gonna select it and then click on import. Now we can see that Excel's showing us a table. It's called table 001 and that runs from page 1 to page 20. It's also showing us all these different pages, but we don't need those. Let's click on this table first. Here we see a preview of that table and it looks like Excel's done a very good job with reading that data. Now we could load it straight into Excel if I press this button load, but I'm gonna click on transform data because it loads up an amazing tool called Power Query. Here's the Power Query editor. We can change the name of our query, which is what's produced this data, by clicking in this box and then renaming it, something more useful. Let's call it Kitchen Sales 1, hit enter. Now there's something pretty interesting that you need to know if you're gonna use Power Query well, and it's in this part here. This section is called Applied Steps. And we can see each of the steps that's been taken by Excel in this box right here, in the order that it's been applied. So the top one is the first step, then we go to second, third, and fourth, and so on if you have more steps. We can actually click on each step like this to see the state of the query at that step. So source just means the file we chose. You can see all of the pages here and the tables on each page. This navigation step happens when we selected that table 001. And you see there's a little formula bar up here that summarizes what's happening at the step. So the third step is promoted headers. What that does is it takes that first row and it promotes that into column headers. So when I click on this, you'll see transaction ID, date, and store moved up. And finally, we have this step called changed type. I want you to keep an eye on this little ABC here and this ABC here. What they represent is the data type of this column, which in this case is ABC for text, and the data type of this column, which again is text. But when I click on changed type, watch what happens here. They've changed to a date format and a whole number format. Now we can actually delete a step if we want by clicking on this red cross next to the step. But I'm pretty happy with our query as it stands. So let's load this to Excel and see what happens. We've got two options. Click on this close and load dropdown. One is close and load. The other is close and load two. If I choose close and load, that creates a new sheet for my query. But I already have a sheet that I want to use, so I'll pick close and load to. So it's asking me to select how you want to view this data in your workbook. I want a table, and it's going to go to an existing worksheet. So B8 is the correct cell, and I'm going to click on OK. So now it's getting the data from the PDF, and there we go. What I'll do though is quickly change the table format, something I like better. And I'll point out that the table name matches the query name. And just like that, we have all our data inside Excel. Wait, what's that? I just got a new email. It's from the company's IT department, and it says the IT system just had an update. So that means there's a new format to the PDFs that I get every month. Oh no, they're saying this might affect how I get data into Excel, but they're sure I'll figure it out. Okay, let's take a look. On level 2, we're going to figure out how to import data from a new format of PDF. So at first glance, nothing's changed. We've got the same header rows. But I'm going to scroll down. You'll see on the second page, there are no header rows. And it's the same for the third page and so on. So we have the same columns, but we don't have any header rows on pages 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 20. And sadly, what this means is that our first query won't work. That's because the original PDF had a header row on each page, like this. And without a header row on each page, Excel can get a bit confused when importing tables. Let's see what happens when we try to get data from the new PDF. We'll go to the Data tab, and then click on the dropdown for Get Data, then From File, From PDF. We'll select the Level 2 file, and then click on Import. Now once that's done, we can see that there's a table on each page, but there isn't one single table like there was before, which had all of the pages in it. That means we're going to have to import all of these tables, and that's going to be a big pain because there are actually 20 of them. Not to mention that they'll all end up on separate sheets inside Excel, unless we can find a way to put them all together into one table. So notice up here, we can select multiple items. Let's check that box, and we can actually tick on all of these to select them. But there is also a faster way. I'll scroll down to table 20, hold Shift, and then click down here. And now I'm going to go to transform the data. So now inside the Power Query editor, we can see all the tables listed on the left. And I want you to pay special attention to the header row. So table 001 has the correct headers, but when I click on table 002, you see they don't have the right names. And the same for table 3, 4, and 5, and so on. So I'm going to make it so that table 1 looks the same as the others. And to do that, I'm going to go to Applied Steps, and remove this changed type, and remove this promoted headers. And you'll see it now shows column 1, column 2, column 3, just like on table 2, which says column 1, 2, and 3. At this point, it's ready to append. And so we can click on this dropdown and select to append queries as new. We need to select 3 or more tables, so we'll select that option. And then I'll choose tables 2 all the way down to 20, and I'll scroll down and hold Shift before clicking on 20, and then click on this Add button, which then brings all the tables together. Then I'll click on OK. Now this new query is called Append 1. I'm going to drag it all the way up to the top, so it's next to Kitchen Sales 1, and then I'm going to rename it here in this box. I'll call it Kitchen Sales 2. And I'll scroll down all the way to the bottom. I'll just keep holding the mouse button and moving left and right. We'll check that it has the last transaction, which is 101866. It does, which is good. And now we'll go back up to the top and click on this button, because all the column headers are actually in row 1. We need to promote them up to the column headers. So click here and then use first row as headers. And now we're ready to load this. So let's click on the drop down. We'll click on Close and Load To. At this point though, I don't want to load to a table. I only want to create a connection. Otherwise, it's going to load all of those tables for every single query, and we don't want that. So I'll click OK. And now you can see there's a connection for Kitchen Sales 2. There are also connections for each of the tables it was loading. Now I'll right click on this and click on Load To. And at this point, I'm going to select Table on the existing worksheet, which is the level 2 worksheet in cell B8, and click on OK. You can see that's getting the data. And now we have our data in a table. I'll just select to change the table format, and we have our data nicely formatted. I'll just click here and press Control and down arrow to see the last transaction, which is correct. Now, if you've come to realize, like me, that Power Query is an awesome skill to have and you want to learn it in depth, check out the resource in the video description below. Okay, so this is all fine, but what if I want to take it to the next level? At the end of every month, I'll get an updated version of the PDF with more data, but I don't want to have to go through all those steps just to get the data into Excel. Is there a way to do this automatically with Power Query? In level 3, we'll do some advanced stuff in Power Query that involves using M-code. You can get a copy of the file with the code in it from the video description. Now, this next bit is going to get a bit heavy, but if it were easy, I wouldn't have to show you, would I? So please stick around even when it seems a bit difficult, because the results will be worthwhile. And when it comes to Power Query, I like to think of M-code as magic code, because it lets us do more complex transformations with our data, just like getting all the tables in a PDF automatically, so we don't have to do it manually. Let me show you how. Here's the M-code that I'll use, and this is what it looks like inside Power Query. Okay, let's copy the M-code, press Ctrl+A to select all, Ctrl+C to copy, and put it inside an empty notepad with Ctrl+V to paste. So we'll need this for easy access when we've got the Power Query screen open. Now let's get data from a file, from a PDF, and we'll select the level 2 PDF. Click on import. We'll just pick that first table here and then click on transform data. I'm going to drag this all the way to the top of the queries list, just here, and then rename it to Kitchen Sales 3. And then I'm going to remove all of the applied steps except for the first one. So I'll click on the red cross next to each of these steps to get rid of it. And we only need this source step because we're going to apply our M code to this step. If we look at the query, you'll see there's this column here called data, and our M code is going to use this column. And now for the magic, we're going to click on this advanced editor button here. So this is the current state of the query. All it's doing is getting the source file. I'm going back into Notepad and selecting all of this text that we copied earlier. Then I'm going to replace the last two lines with the text with Ctrl+V. Now you'll see there's an error at the bottom because we need to do one adjustment at the top. We need to get rid of this line here and the let. So there can only be one let at the top instead of two. And this is the correct source that we used in our initial query. This one here is just a placeholder that ChatGPT has generated for me. So we need to get rid of these two lines. I'll select them, press backspace, and then another backspace. And then notice there is a token comma expected. So that's because there's a comma missing at the end of this line. I'll add one in now and look back again here. There's no syntax errors. So the way this query works is from the top down, you can read these green lines, which are comments, to understand what's going on. But in brief, that first step here is getting the source file, which is the level 2 file we have. The second bit here filters to include only the rows where the kind is table, because we want to exclude pages. Then we're extracting all the tables from the data column. Remember this data column, which we saw earlier. And then we're using the first table, which is table 001, for headers. So we're assuming table 001 is the first table and that it contains the column names. Next, we're going to fix the headers for all the other tables, because remember, the problem we have with this PDF is that none of the other pages have column headers. And finally, we're going to combine all the tables into one. Let's click Done, and that will load up the query. Now we can scroll all the way down to see how many rows this has, and we're expecting it to have 1,400 rows. And there we go. 10866 is the correct transaction ID for the last transaction. So the final step is to close and load this. So we're going to click on Close and Load 2, and we'll select a table, then an existing worksheet, and cell B8 is good. So I'll click OK. Then I'll change the table format to the one I like better. And here we go. We have Kitchen Sales 3 loaded into this table. Let's refresh the query for a new file. But first, we should scroll down to the bottom of this table, and you can see the last transaction happened on June 17th in Chicago. Here is the new PDF. It's called Level 3. I've opened it inside Adobe Reader, and I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom. And you can see the last transaction is 102000 that happened on June the 30th in Seattle. So heading back to Excel, we're going to right-click on Kitchen Sales 3 and edit that query. Now, this is the beauty of the M code that we wrote. We don't have to make any changes to any of these steps. In fact, the only thing we need to do is change the source file, which we do by clicking on this gear icon. Let's select a new file by clicking on Browse. It's the Level 3 file we want, so let's click on that and click on Import, and then click on OK. We can click on Change Type, the last step, and we can see the final table. Let's scroll down, and we can see the last transaction is 102000, which happened on June 30th in Seattle, just like in our PDF. So we can then close and load to bring this back into Excel. So that's how using MCode can help you automatically include all tables from a PDF if they have the same columns. But the more you know about Power Query, the more you realize that it can do so much more than this. For example, I imported a financial summary for Tesla into Excel and cleaned it up by removing the rows and columns that I didn't want to keep. Watch this video next to learn how I did it.